Greetings, North Brantford, and welcome to our Fall Thunder Center. It's been a while since our last time together, but we've been very busy here at the studio to prepare for the upcoming weeks.
Let's start off the show by taking a trip through the woods of Totucket Park while we piggyback off of the cross-country team. Nate has his shoes laced up for this one.
Here at North Brantford, our cross-country team had a very successful season. Even though they're small, they have a lot to be proud of. Take a look.
After starting the season at Cromwell, our T-Birds came home to play at Totucket Valley Park. HK, Old Lyme, Morgan, Old Saybrook, and Valley came to compete. Although the team is too small to be competitive right now, they are
working to improve our form. That's been a big thing this year. A lot of us, we have had some faulty form in the past, and so it's fixing those issues.
The team has also worked on improving their times and pacing. On November 1st, the team ran a Halloween candy-fueled race at the Mega Meet. Although the team is too small to place, the individual runners have a lot to be proud of. Sam Gott, a sophomore, ran the 5K in 20:52. Carolyn Heffernan, a junior, ran a 25:38. And Zach Chittenden, a senior captain, ran a 23:34. Our small team has also experienced some setbacks this year.
My goal is to finish the season without many team injuries, because right now a lot of us aren't running in this next meet because, we got hurt and our team is already small enough.
Zach is proud of the team's performance this year.
So the team is doing fairly well this season. Individually, all our times have been moving downwards. We've been improving our PBs. Everyone is doing very well in practice, and we're relaying that in meets, and it's just a great thing to see.
Though this season may have seen some challenges, the future of the team is bright.
Hopefully we're going to get more people. Right now we don't have any freshmen, so we're just six people, three boys, three girls. But I've heard there's a lot of people running at the middle school, 40 or 50 kids. So hopefully we'll get some new freshmen next year if we go out and recruit some.
Even though they're too small to be competitive right now, our T-Birds have a lot to be proud of. Here's to next year with a million more kids. For the T-Bird News, I'm Nate Higgins.
The boys' soccer team once again fed off each other's team chemistry and heart. Paul Rathbone was on the sideline bringing you the corner kick. What do you have for us, Paul?
The soccer team was very busy this season. Let me show you.
They played several tough games throughout the course of the season, but that did not stop them from giving maximum effort. Captains Dimitrios Teodosio, Michael Virginelli, and Nick Prostakis focused on building positive relationships with the team while bonding with one another. The boys ended the season on a high note by scoring goals in their last three games against Hail Ray and Platte Tech home and away. Freshman Alex Guerrero has been an up-and-coming player, being the leading goal scorer for this past season. Coach Dewey Boatman reflected on the season and what to look forward to.
I thought we did amazing. Given that where we are, all the boys came out, they tried hard, they didn't quit. They worked together and they were truly a team. So I thought, given that, we did an amazing job. And we hope to build on that for next year. The guys worked hard. We stuck together, which was very important. And we had a very tough season, but we didn't quit. And I think that's is huge. And that's a good lesson that will carry these boys throughout their life. For improvement, we're going to need some more guys. Last year, we had a very small bench, and I think for us to be in games more competitively, that we need more players. And I'm going to say, if anyone wants to join the soccer team, we're looking for our first win in a while, and if anyone wants to be part of that, I think it's going to be a big deal. So hope you guys come out.
I also got to speak with the senior captains. Here are their thoughts.
We got a really young team with a lot of promising talent, so I'm hoping that next year our boys will be able to compete for states.
Everybody showed more overall improvement throughout this season. Guys really glued together. Chemistry was up compared to last year. Obviously, scoring goals is also a huge takeaway.
A lot of improvement this year compared to last year. We had a few goals scored by our season by Nick, Alex, and Nate. I've seen a lot of improvement from the team. A lot of guys stepped up, and I haven't really put everything they had out on the field compared to last year, and we just had an overall pretty decent season, pretty fun with the boys.
They plan to come back in full force for next year. For Thunder Center, I'm Paul Rathbone.
Flipping to girls soccer, led by first-year coach and former NBA alumni Kelly Kennedy, the T-Birds were looking to build on the positive atmosphere this year. Carly Parenti was at midfield to take us into their huddle.
The girls' soccer team had a lot of fun this season, both on and off the field. I was there to check out their skills. The girls' soccer team sprinted into this season with a bunch of new players joining the team. They battled hard on senior night, only losing by 2 to Double L School Norwich Free Academy. I talked to senior captain Lexi Marcarelli to hear more about their season.
So I would say my favorite memory was getting an own goal the second game of the season.
Captains Grace Mara and Ava Candelora were huge standouts this year, with Grace scoring 100% of the team's goals and Ava making 35 saves in one game. I got to hear from them both how it's going.
So our goals were to basically just improve every practice and every game, but to most importantly have fun throughout the whole season, and I think we accomplished that, so I'm pretty happy about that.
If I had to give advice to future players, I would tell them to not take it too seriously and that stats and winning don't matter. It's all about improvement and to just go out with a positive attitude and play your hardest each game, even if like the outcome isn't in our favor.
With a lot of players gaining varsity experience this year, the future is looking bright for the girls' soccer team. 2012 alumni and first-year coach Kelly Kennedy told me about her experiences with the team.
My goals as a first-year coach were to build the program first, because it was a difficult season going in, and to get girls to play. And then I guess a second goal would have been to help educate girls and get them to learn the game of soccer so that they would want to come back next year and hopefully recruit more people to play.
Go Birds!
It's safe to say there's never a dull moment with the girls' soccer team. For T-Bird News, I'm Carly Parenti.
Bump, set, and spike. The volleyball team came back strong this season and battled each opponent hard. Sam Helwig was in the crow's nest following the action.
This year, the volleyball team was ready for some action. I was on the court to get a better look. This year, the volleyball team was able to get 6 wins under their belt, beating Valley, East Haven, and Brantford. With most of the team being seniors, they all got a chance to play together for one last season. I got to talk to captains Carly Parenti and Marissa Vaccaro on this season and what they're going to miss next year.
Our goals for this season were really just to refine our skills and get some wins under our belt, especially compared to previous seasons. And I definitely think we accomplished that. And also just to have a good senior year, you know, because the majority of our team this year was seniors, so we really just wanted to make the most of the time we had left on the team.
I think I'm gonna miss bus rides the most, because just getting hyped with everyone before games is just so much fun, and also just being on the court with all my fellow seniors is gonna really be sad to leave behind.
Not only did I get to talk to the captains, I got to talk to their coach, Tori Ramada, and see how she thought the season went.
So this year, the season went really well. We had 9 seniors who played a lot of varsity last year, and they worked well in the offseason, so they came ready to play. Although our record didn't really indicate the talent that we had on our team, we couldn't be more proud of their progress and how well they did. Next year, we are losing the 9 seniors, so the underclassmen have big shoes to fill, but they're definitely, we have faith in them, they're capable. And, you know, just look towards improving for the next season. We finished our record this season was 6-14, so we'll just look to improve it next year.
Even though their record may not have shown it, the volleyball team was stronger than ever this year.
The North Brantford football season was back in action. We won't spoil it for you here, but once again, Sam is on the goal line for this one.
The football team finally got a chance to play a full season this year. Players were very excited to have some competition on the gridiron. Led by a large number of juniors, the team was able to use this year to build chemistry and familiarize themselves with the plays. They had a tough game against Haddam Killingworth, pulling through with a win 28-27. They also had a good game against Creck, winning 26-21. Each game tested their perseverance, but also allowed them to grow into themselves. Their record doesn't reflect the effort and passion they put out game after game. The captains are Eric Izzo, Mason Provinger, Dom Langello, and David D'Onofrio. I got to talk to Dom and Eric on their thoughts about this season and how they will be prepared for next year.
So building off of this year, we're all juniors, so we're not really losing anything, and every other team that we play against like loses a lot of players. So there's nowhere we could go but up after this season, even though we didn't have that good of a season.
Our goals for this season was to rebuild. We lost a big senior class last year, and we had a lot of young guys stepping up to play varsity. So we're really looking forward to next year to have a full-strength team with a strong senior class.
If the T-Birds use this year as a learning experience, it will be a step in the right direction for next year's season.
One common denominator that has been at the football games year in and year out are the cheerleaders. Paul Vafum grabs the pom-poms to tell us what they are all about.
While still doing a lot for the community, the cheerleaders found a way to cheer along. Let me show you how their season went.
With football being back in full force, it also means that the cheerleaders can be seen showing off their school spirit once again. Throughout the course of the fall, their main goal is to come up with cheer routines that get the crowd excited for each play. Many even know some of these cheers by heart now. The occasional "Let's Go T-Birds" rings throughout the stands at Colafati Field. The fall season is only part one of what the cheerleaders do. They are also getting ready for competition season, which is the second major part of their season. They also did a lot with the community. They had the youth cheerleaders with them for their halftime performance. I spoke with the cheer captains as well as Coach Slabowski to get their thoughts.
First off, we included the little girls from TBES, MBIS, and some girls that had friends that were cheerleaders, and we did a couple practices, taught them some routines, and they got a point of view of what high school games were like, and we did a halftime routine with them, and everyone was included. And then another thing we did was we made t-shirts to throw in the crowds to interact with students, get some school spirit going.
In terms of the football season, we did really good with the crowd. The student section really loves us this year, and we have a better relationship with the boys.
So we started comp practices last week, and we're doing really good so far. We have more of a variety of stunting and tumbling, so we think we'll have a very successful comp season.
So obviously our main focus for the fall season is football. We prepare for this by learning cheers, jumps, dances, just a lot of stuff to engage the crowd. And we actually really enjoyed this season because there was a lot of crowd engagement, and we have a lot more good ideas for next year. So we're really looking forward to next season and how we can bring the school together more.
Well, you heard it here first. From T-Bird News, I'm Paul Raffone.
Did you know that each of the sports here at NVHS have one thing in common?
Yeah, it's Sam.
Me?
No, not you, Sam. Sam Donahue, the athletic trainer here at North Brantford High School. He has been a staple the last 4 years in the athletic department. Even though he was camera shy, we wanted to highlight the important role he plays here at North Brantford High School.
The sports season can be a grind. This means plenty of bumps, sprains, and injuries are bound to happen. That's where our athletic trainer Sam comes in. Sam is entering his fifth year as the NVHS athletic trainer. In that time, he's become someone many of our athletes know and rely on. His love for sports led him to attend Quinnipiac University, where he pursued his athletic training career.
When I was a senior in college, my rotation for proficiencies was at North Brantford High School under Stacy's tutelage. And when she was going back to school, she had asked me if I wanted to be the full-time athletic trainer.
If there's an injury on the field or court, Sam is always the first responder. On a daily basis, he can be found in his office pre-treating players by wrapping muscles and ligaments so everyone can head into their games with confidence. I asked him what some of his favorite parts of his job are.
I would have to say developing and gaining a good positive rapport with the athletes, parents, and coaches alike, and making sure people are their best when they're on the field.
He's a very good trainer. He tapes me every game, and he's very good at it.
Although much of his job is behind the scenes, Sam is the reason sports can run smoothly at North Brantford High School. For T-Bird News, I'm Carly Parenti.
Now, to wrap up this final Thunder Center, we have to talk about how awesome of a season the field hockey team is having yet again. They have been one of the most successful programs in the fall and even throughout the entire school year, the past 10 years. Led by legendary coach Bobby Noon, the team once again was hungry for success. Nate Higgins took us in.
Field hockey is on track to have an excellent season this year. Let me show you. Field hockey is one of the most accomplished sports here at North Brantford High School, with a four-year streak of Shoreline Championship wins. This season, the team is looking to continue the streak and be even stronger than last year. The season started a little rough when the T-Birds lost their first game against Valley, focusing them. The next game, North Brantford won 7-0 against Westbrook, who continued to win until they faced Valley again and tied. The team had their Play for a Cure game on October 13th against Shaw. They beat Shaw 3-0, and team captain Olivia Toto scored two goals.
Well, I did score two goals, but it wouldn't have happened without my teammates behind me. We had a really great breakaway, and we were just able to execute the play really, really well. And like I said, if our defense didn't get the ball up the field, it never would have happened. So, gotta give it to my teammates.
The team has worked hard to improve this year. Mia Park, a junior on the team, talks about what the team has done to grow.
The team is working on playing more together, which really helps us score goals.
For the future of the team captains are optimistic about where the team is headed.
We have five seniors graduating this year, so definitely not as many as last year. Last year we had eight or nine graduate. So we are a young team. I think that the future is strong. There's a lot of talent in the freshman, sophomore, junior classes that are going to be returning next year. And then from what I've seen at the middle school team, they have a great coach and a great program down there. So I think that the future of our field hockey program is bright.
Definitely think the future of our team is very bright. We have a lot of underclassmen that kind of stepped up this year and are taking on a lot of responsibilities and just taking on a lot of new roles. So I definitely think the future of our program is definitely bright with all of our young players stepping up.
Besides their record, the team has more to tell about the season. Here is Braden LeBeau on how the team has grown this year.
So this season, some of our main goals are to make it far in the Shoreline and State Tournament. We lost a lot of senior starters last year. We only had a few returning starters and varsity players, so we are really looking forward to rebuilding a lot of the positions and trying to make it far. We're doing, I think, way better than any of us imagined that we could. We really came together, and we have so much young skill, and everyone really stepped up a lot. So our goal is to make it to the Shoreline Finals and then make it pretty far in states, too.
The Lady T-Birds ended the regular season second overall in Shoreline. At Shoreline, our T-Birds faced Valley in a close game that ended 2-1, with our field hockey team returning with a trophy. Another remarkable feat is that Coach Babby Noon has been coaching for 40 seasons. Even though she was camera shy, she had this to say about her team. Our philosophy is to play hard from the first second of the game to the final whistle to end the game. And that's what we needed to do today. We don't celebrate anything until that final whistle is blown. At Wethersfield, Connecticut, our field hockey team took the field against Stonington for the state championship. They came, they saw, and they conquered, winning 2-0, with one goal scored by Olivia Toto and another by Mia Oliverio. The team is home now with the fifth title in program history. Congratulations, Lady T-Birds, on your state's win. Here's to another great and successful season next year. For the T-Bird News, I'm Nate Higgins. How about that? One sports season done and dusted. This year is just flying by. We hope you all have a wonderful Thanksgiving and enjoy time with family and friends.
Be safe and have fun, North Brantford.
Roll Birds!